If you are building an application using a relational database, then you should definitely consider using a database migration tool like Flyway or Liquibase. These database migration tools help you to version control your database changes and deploy these database changes along with your application code in automated way. Let us see how IntelliJ IDEA can help you to work with Flyway database migrations in a Spring Boot application. Here, I have a Spring Boot application with starter data JPA with PostgreSQL driver. Also, I have added Flyway dependencies to work with PostgreSQL database. And also, I have a PostgreSQL database running on my local. I have connected to it from my database tools here. So right now, there are no tables in this database. Let us start with creating a JPA entity called bookmark. So here, I have created an entity called bookmark with properties ID, title, URL, published at, created at, and updated at. And I have setters and getters for those properties. So once we have a JPA entity, now we want to create a Flyway database migration for creating this table. Instead of creating a migration script manually, we can leverage IntelliJ IDEA feature to generate Flyway database migration script from the JPA entities. So if you go to persistence tool window, here you can right click on it, new, and here you can see Flyway init migration. So once you click on it, it will select what is the source for this migration script. So we want to create a migration script from our JPA entity model. So select the model and you can choose which database type you want to generate the script for. Here we are using PostgreSQL. So I have selected PostgreSQL here. Click OK. So depending on the JPA entity structure, it is going to generate automatically the script that is going to create the bookmarks table. So here I will give the name create bookmarks table.sql. Save. So here you can see under SRC main resources DB migration folder, it created our first migration script. Now let us start our application and Spring Boot will take care of checking if there are any pending migrations to be applied and then it will execute those scripts. Here you can refresh this and we should be able to see there are two tables created right now. One is bookmarks based on our JPA entity bookmark. And also there is a Flyway schema history table which keeps track of what are all the Flyway migration scripts that are already executed and what is the status of execution. Is it successfully executed? Is it failed? Something like that. Here you can see which version is this script and a description about it and the file name. And also you can see it created a checksum so that it can verify the integrity of it. Once a Flyway migration is applied successfully, you should not change the script because it's going to compare the checksum and if it mismatches, it is going to throw the exception. Now that we have applied our first migration successfully, let us create another JPA entity called category. So we are going to categorize all our bookmarks into various categories. So here I have created a category JPA entity which has ID and name properties. And here I'm going to update in my bookmarks entity with a many-to-one association from bookmark to category. So here I have added category many-to-one association from bookmark to category. Also, I would like to add another property that defines whether the current bookmark is archived or active. So here I have defined another property with a default of false. Also, currently I have a created at and published at properties, but I decided I don't need published at property. I just use created at. So I decided to delete this property and I can remove these setters and getters for it. Also, let me generate both setters and getters for category and archived properties here. So now that I changed this bookmark entity and also I have created a new JPA entity, now I need to generate a new Flyway migration script for these changes. How do I do it? Again, I can go ahead and create manually a new migration script or I can use IntelliJ feature to automatically inspect the current JPA structure and compare it with the database structure and generate the script automatically. Let us do that. So here again, this time instead of Flyway init migrations, I'm going to choose Flyway migration, and the source is the JPA entity model and the target is database structure. So here, if I click OK, as you can see here, based on the changes that we made to our JPA model, it generated various scripts, and you can inspect the green color representation is nothing but a safe operation. And here you can see some changes are in yellow color, which means you need to pay a little bit attention because we are going to modify something that could affect some performance issues or some data collisions or something like that. And also there is one in red color, which represents a kind of a destructive operation, probably deleting a column or deleting the data or something like that. So you need to be careful while applying these kind of a migrations. So here you need to review all the generated operations and then carefully consider, okay, I want to delete the published red column. So move it to here. Now you can go ahead and give it a name. I'll make a change, add category dot SQL, save. So here you can see the second migration is created with all the changes to the database based on the changes I made to our JPA model. So now that we have this, let us restart the application. So it is going to apply the second migration, which is not yet applied. Now if we take a look at here, you can see we have a categories table created. And also here you can take a look at the columns here. We can see we have archived and category ID columns. And here you can inspect the second migration is also applied successfully. So this is how IntelliJ can help you to work with Flyway migrations from your JPA model. You don't have to write these migration scripts by hand. If you are following a model first approach where you start with JPA entities instead of writing the database scripts first, you can use IntelliJ IDEA's feature to easily generate these scripts. If you want to learn more about how to tackle real world database migration challenges, you can read this Database Migrations in the Real World blog post on JetBrains blog. You can find the link to this article in the video description.